All the butterflies. There they are, some more on the Porter's Reef. See the Longwing and the Gulf Fritillary. These are already on the Monarch. His common name is B-bomb. Maybe just a little bit of the sun hits it some more and warms it up a little bit more, and they'll be all over right here. See, I'm starting to swarm all over. See, I'm darting about. And they're always all over here because they have a passion flower vine that's kind of taken over, and I don't really care because we get all these butterflies, caterpillars that turn into butterflies, and then I have my pea vine. Blooms has a skipper on it, and the long-tailed skippers actually lay their eggs on the pea vine. So there are two host plants right here, and there you can see right where the skipper is up here. You can see there's a Gulf Fritillary caterpillar. And the zebra longwings also lay their eggs on it, but in the more shady parts, because they don't like, you know, lay their eggs in the sun. The Gulf Fritillaries do that. So they're really not competing for the same spots, even though the Gulf Fritillary thinks that everything that flies through the yard is competing with it, and they try to bully everything and make it go away. Monarchs, everybody. There's a female back there. There she go, laying eggs on the vine. Very territorial. Monarchs. And the porter weed, the nectar also. And then another blue butterfly vine. And then there's the firebush. The firebush here is a native. The firebush and the passion flower both are here because I had potted one sitting here that grew into the ground, and when we pulled them up, the roots that were left behind grew up into bushes and vines. And this is an orchid. Blooms like all the time. Butterfly seemed to like it also. Rosemary. Right there's rosemary. Here's the porter weed that we saw the butterflies on before. That's a zebra longwing on there now. That's the Florida state butterfly. There's another one. Chase the other one off. And there are my garlic chives that bloom all the time. And they actually, the blooms actually smell sweet. And up there is the Natchez crepe myrtle, and their blooms actually smell like lilacs. They're wonderful. I love it. And the bees and butterflies like it too. And then just some of my pots of things, a lot of different curcuma gingers, lily, and then there's my Costus camosus. Camosus used to be cosmosis, whatever it is. It used to be Costus barbatus. And they decided it wasn't. Still my favorite ginger, I don't care what they call it. My gosh, does she always have to make that horrid noise? And there's a couple zebra longwings. Probably female is gonna lay. See, they like the shady spots underneath the eave of the house. I'm coming, Azalee. Sorry, I was watching the butterflies. I'm watching the butterflies.